This is our cryo bank. So you can see the cryo preservation bank, it is written here, and it is fully secure. Like with the lock also you cannot open it. You have got a finger sensor, the embryologist has got it. With that only you can go inside. This is also properly locked. So it is like three locks, one lock here, one here, and then with this lock we again open it here. So these are the liquid nitrogen filled, all the embryos, sperms and oocyte bank is here. So this is the place where all your sperms, eggs and embryos are frozen, maybe for, we cannot say infinite, but right now we are keeping it for whatsoever time the patient wishes. So it is not that after 10 years it is going to be wasted or you have to throw it. You can preserve your gametes, and your gametes will be at the same stage as on the day it had been frozen. The science has become so much advanced. So basically now it is ageless, because you have aged out, but your babies, these embryos or your gametes, they haven't aged out. So the details and all, how this is done, how the freezing process is done and everything, that will be again explained by our senior embryologist who do this procedure.
This is our storage liquid nitrogen tank, in which we store excess of liquid nitrogen to top up our tanks weekly once. This is our main tank, in which all the embryos, all the sperms and all the oocytes of our patients are stored. We have a special type of liquid nitrogen alarm, which on the tap of a phone tells us whether the liquid nitrogen is present or not. In case of any emergency or leakage in the nitrogen tank, we are aware so that our patient's embryo, oocytes or sperms are intact and topped up with liquid nitrogen frequently. This is a goblet in which all the embryos of patients are being stored. This is for multiple patients. Each straw is labeled and with a minimum of three identifiers so that there is no mixing of embryos, sperms or as well as oocytes.